afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another exciting, riveting, amazing propaganda cast from your host, Imperial Dane, Master Propaganda, here of Psych Defender of the Fatherland. Off here to an exciting one versus one. On Arnhem Checkpoint, the South Forgot Luciano, fighting for America, freedom, democracy. The 2nd Armor Division, I believe, rank 30 or 40 player here with the Americas, but they're all sort of, even with some faction, around rank 20. In the North, you got Nosmarkov, who I can't quite find easily, at least because there's this weird symbol, which just makes him really difficult to find. He's on the leaderboards. Anyways, but I suspect he's also reasonably high ranked. Fighting here for the German army, a Deutschland, taking on the role of the 9th Panzer Division here with Overwatch. Triple Infantry, first engagement on the center of the German army, assaulting is out here for Luciano, as he pushes out armor, triple infantry bulletins as well for him. Certainly armor with assaulting and a heavy start is certainly popular with some American players, so certainly, I mean, in that sense, while there has been some hiccups resulting in a lot of Jaeger-like infantry, at the same time, from at least from an American perspective, they are now a greater number of strategies being enacted, so. I mean, that is something, you know, worth keeping in mind. Folks moving up here, Sturm Pony as well, pushing around for the center. Luciano spreading out for the flanks, very good here. I mean, he could try and deal with this, but he better off just try and sort of bait him into more manual engagement, cutting him down. Assault units moving up westwards there with their grease guns. Sturm Pony advancing here for Nosmarkov. Advancing aggressively. Avoiding kicking over anything. Nice work there. Rifleman eastwards, the rear sons each retreat to. They're about to get dead. If they're not careful, more rifle falling up here for Luciano. Ooh, that's definitely awkward. In this case, they're saved by the fact the Sturm Pony is a really terrible DPS at the longer ranges. Hitting the eastern field point. Sonius looks like they're moving now from the west towards the center here. Might try and ambush the Foxes, get up closer, so if they can do that, they can do some heavy damage there with their grease guns, which is basically just an attempt by the Americans to make a submachine gun that had the same firepower in a sense, like the Thompson, but much lighter and much cheaper, since the Thompson was expensive to make and really heavy for a submachine gun, which is actually quite impractical. Rifleman seizing the point in the east, pursuing the folks over the grease gun, peppering them there with the 45 caliber rounds. Certainly not something you want to be on the receiving end of. Rifleman up here, and we got Leeson moving up westwards there. So far, aggressive control here, but also Markov. That's kind of, though, what the Orbital Commandos wants to do. It wants to get in early, you know, establish at least an initial lead, and then sort of try and, you know, stall off that until they sort of get into a decent late game. If you can sort of, you know, push back against that early game, you usually have a good chance. So that's rather the trick here now for Luciano versus Nosmarkov. More folks on the way there for Nosmarkov for the German army. So he's moving up here. Very good move there. Should probably try and pull out, then close in. But does allow the folks there to get away. Need to reconnect the fuel as well. There'll be gut that the folks are covering up. And Nosmarkov, I think, is sort of very deftly just falling back here ever so slightly. Just try and draw in Luciano slowly and not try and lose too many men here pointlessly. Worth noting, though, that Luciano does have theoretically the possibility of getting a fuel edge on Nosmarkov, since he's been so focused on disrupting Luciano's early game. Hasn't been, obviously, super successful. Oh, he's got a read here. Oh, close one there. Almost looked like they're going to try and pop into the house at the same time, in case we've got into the first, of course, would likely win, but not quite what's happening here. Sturm Pony, in fact, now in a really bad house to be fighting from, so there's only one window. Karl von Rees secured. Jaeger's out here, and there he goes, pops into the house, which Luciano had left unattended now. Following in and going for the curve point. Once more, in the west region, they're being assaulted by the Volksgrenadiers. More rifle on there for Luciano. No sign of tech as of yet. No lieutenant, no captain. Assault units getting the flamethrowers up. That's going to be absolutely crucial here around with all this fighting around the eastern carve point and the houses here. Brutal attritional fighting here with Luciano so far. Rather not having a huge advantage in this, partly thanks to the Jaeger round. But there you go, flamethrowers going to try and turn this around. Trotting away from Nosmarkov. Could be Belgrade headquarters, could be mechanized, but the flamethrower is definitely a big game changer for Luciano. As long as the men actually, you know, fire properly, which they aren't. So I think he's trying to get up to the angle so he can actually use the Sturm Pony inside the very narrow house there, rifling up towards the center here. He needs to get that tech going. I do believe he got tech up there. In fact, it is the lieutenant up for Luciano, platoon command post. He's going to go for an aggressive sort of opening here in that sense. Well, aggressive early to mid game, I'll say, shift there. Might try and pop out of Stuart. Of course, also the 5th cal here to help deal with all the infantry. And worth noting, Nosmarkov has a lot of it. 4 folks going to use the Sturm Ponies and the Jaegers. That is a ton of infantry, and he's likely going to go for the Battle of Headquarters to support all of this, since otherwise it's going to be difficult to keep all of these men healed, I think, reasonably well long-term. Heading east was the depleted rifleman. Luciano, of course, knows he has to sort of keep up pressure that way. Lieutenant, I imagine, is getting ever closer. Rifleman can't hold up for much longer. He also, of course, is going to need an ambulance at some point. So there's a lot of challenges here for Luciano. A lot of things he needs. A very large shopping list. Still, he has successfully pushed Nosmarco out of the eastern half there. So that's a good start. That's all he's moving out there with a flamethrower. Arrived in advance. We've got the folks of them moving in to shift in there to try and deal with this flanking attempt here. By Luciano and the second armored. 9th Panzer Division is having absolutely none of that. And it is actually the mechanized regiment he does go for. What's actually kind of expecting a battle group headquarters here. But, I mean, on a map like this as well, I mean, mechanized is also a strong choice. It looks could be a really big pain for Luciano to deal with. Of course, that's also the reason he could be going for the lieutenant. So he can that way get out a steward if he has to. Jaeger's moving up here. No upgrades as of yet. A lot of munitions being spent on, say, medics. Ambulance on the way there for Luciano first, plus the unlock there for the platoon command post. Big 2 points being seized, cut point being hit again. Van Hunt Granada at the exit, catching here Luciano's lieutenant. Nice throw there by Nosmarkov. Troops reinforcing. Ambulance almost done. Still, it's going to be some time off there. Sadly, no 50 caliber yet. That would certainly also be in a good priority. But then again, so many things are essentially priority here for Luciano. Doing part charge on the lieutenant, that's actually a really poor move, particularly across negative cover. The lieutenant with the submachine gun there is still really powerful, so he was able to do some heavy damage to the Sturm Pioneers. Didn't quite get a wipe, but even then, quite an impact there. In the far west, Riesen sneaking up there, nice harassment there by Luciano. Good map control there, go healing reinforcement going on there. Well, in a sense, he's got a good grasp of the map, he's not exactly who's controlling it, but I would say he's sort of handling things decently. Flares off here in the west, though he needs to be still on the point. Jaeger's out to stop this. Quite expensive in terms of manpower. I mean, Nosmarco now is floating a lot of manpower in the sense of a lot of infantry. You've got 48 Volksgrenadiers, 2 Jaegers, and a Sturm Pioneer squad. That's a lot of manpower just in infantry. Troops are healing and forcing. Luciano making a big sweep here. Volksgrenadiers, Assongineers, moving east there to grab a few Pioneers and pushed away from the east. Nosmarco, though, is rather scattered in terms of defense. There's certainly a good chance Luciano can rout him aggressively. Soon the Jaegers here, grab the cutoff point here. Of course, needs to grab back here as well. Deny it to Nosmarco. The Jaegers completely push back. Got a big push here though with Nosmarco. Falling into counterattack and stop Luciano's push into the east. Back here, troops getting ready again. Some time for him to go out for anything at the moment. Again, the manpower bleed early on was quite severe. There we go, going to charge the Foxes here with the Assault Engineers. Flamethrowers can deny the caliber bonus here to them, will at least make it a very unpleasant thing. And there go, Foxes going to be his routed. Lieutenant finally gets the Foxes there. Lots of action, lots of intense. And we got minesweepers up here, just in case that Nosmarco has been mined. Of course, it also disables the flares, by the way, there, so they don't pop off if there's a minesweeper still seizing them. So that's a little fun detail there as well. I believe it's like that. Looks the way for Nosmarco. Luciano's going to need that steward out, I think, because otherwise he has no real way of stopping that looks that's about to hit him. He's not far off from the steward, though, and I imagine Luciano's got a pretty decent idea about what's going to hit him. At least one hopes. At least he's going to be aware of it soon enough. But there you go, harassment, cutting off points. They're trying to outmaneuver Nosmarco, trying to avoid any engagement he can't win. Very good move there, I would say, by Luciano, doing the next best thing in those situations here. He's almost got the fuel there for the steward. He's roughly got the manpower there as well. Still, very good harassment there by Luciano. Good maneuvering. Lux is out. But Luciano's now got control of most of the map here. He can go for the steward now, and I imagine he's going to go for it as soon as possible, or at least he's going to go for it once Lux begins chewing up his infantry. Though, of course, sooner would be better. And there goes Stuart Light hanging on the way there for Luciano for the second armament. Got Luke's pursuing here, Raven caught out in the open, forced to retreat here across negative cover. He could maybe try and catch him under tank rifle, which would slow down Nosmarco a bit further. Eastern point there being hit again. Nosmarco springing out west to reconnect the fuel there, of course. Veteran to the assault units, very good there for Luciano. Fun note about American assault units, those sort of independent assets, sort of on the core level, I believe, where they'd be attached wherever needed. Whereas, like with the Germans, the assault pioneers essentially were a you know, divisional asset that goes, you know, that way work. Though, of course, they're also high-level units in that sense. The soldiers caught by the looks. Almost got the steward, though. Got the car point back at the very least. I imagine here that Luciano's going to make a bigger push for the Stuart Light Tank and try and force Mas Marco back with that. And there you go. M5A1 Stuart Light Tank at Luciano. Mas Marco's going to be in for a bit of a rough ride there, since he's got otherwise no anti-tank weapons. Adding a bazooka there as well. Not a bad idea there. Moving up here, Stuart supporting the infantry. Certainly by late war, the Stuart was primarily sort of meant for infantry support as the Greyhound took over sort of reconnaissance. Little fun fact there. Of course, they're being pushed back with the M5 Stuart Light Tank. Almost got a wipe here. That'd be certainly helpful here for Luciano. I didn't quite land it. Mas Marco following up here with a Puma. The 234-2. Of course, they're moving up. Might try and flank here and sneak out in Panzerfaust. A bit risky there. Assault is almost good to go. Pearson's reinforcing. 50 cal, I still think would be a nice choice here for Luciano. Looks hammering away there. Big 2 points wise, it's reasonably close between the two. There we go. Puma mobilized here for Mas Markov. Another option for Luciano could also just be going for weapon racks, getting out bars and bazookas. That could also work out quite well. Looks here close to being destroyed, but does manage to gain Veterans 1. Trying to get another wipe here, but once more it does seem that Lady Fortune smiles upon Mas Marco there just a bit. Stuart with 5 kills, so we've got the Puma about. He should be able to see it here by with the Lieutenant in the house. Does give extended line of sight there for units inside, so that should inform him there's a Puma nearby and he can't move ahead there. I imagine Mas Marco is also aware of that, while he's just keeping it there rather than get too close. Weapon racks for Luciano. I imagine the Riesens will be getting some bazookas to help deal with the Lux and the Puma, until he's going to need the bazookas to put some fear of democracy into that heavy armored car. As he could easily risk losing the Stuart Light Tank here. Oh, he might be making a mistake here, pushing the Stuart too far ahead. And the Puma, there you go. Vision block there. Blocked. Might be able to pop an anti-tank rifle up something else on it. So far, nice on that. Riesons should be able to grab the bazookas now. Stuart falling back for a bit of repairs. Nice push into the west. Even as he's pushing up the center, there, it more or less seems to be like bait or distraction here for Mas Marco to focus as Luciano then hits the side pods there. Very nice work here. Very nice. Mines moves up as well here for Mas Marco. He's clearly worried about enemy mines. Not a bad idea to be worried about that. Got Riesons moving out. Bazooka's now equipped. Forming a nice little anti-tank team. There we go. Mines as well on the car point. There we go. Bazooka fire there. Most missing. Still, that's going to keep the looks a bit more honest. And for that matter, the Puma as well. So Luciano here is slowly getting a bit more ground here. A bit more traction. Versus Mas Marco and the 9th Panzer Division. Riesons turning ahead here. Full bazooka volley. Possibly inbound, but not quite there. Most seem to be fumbling about with the bazooka. On the other hand, Puma there forced to pop smoke and get away there. Bit of an awkward spot. Machine gun following up for Luciano to help deal with the infantry, to help slow down Luciano's movements. I imagine particularly to help keep those anti-tank teams a bit more honest. Back here, healing reinforcement. Back here, healing reinforcement as well there, except he lacks the steering part. Well, if they can, he should just, you know, throw that down. But he isn't so far. There we go. Still could have asked from the left side, but Luciano stood moving ahead there pretty aggressively. He should be a bit concerned that possible mines from Mas Markov, since that could make the suit a very easy target for the Puma, and that's not something you should be wanting. Puma moving westwards. Directed here on the Stuart Light Tank. Second shot misses. Back here, troops healing reinforcing. We do get the 50 cal out here for Luciano. We'll have to see what ends up next. I mean, he's going to have to take out at some point to bring out Yasmal and the M10s if he wants those. As for Mas Marco, he's probably going to be taking out as well soon enough. Though even him's going to have a bit of a hard time getting out of armor. Far from pushing away the photons in the west. Very good, very good. Bigger push into the east. 50 Cal being moved in to deal with that. Sonji's moving up here as well. Flares exploding, exposing Luciana's tendrils as he creeps them towards those Markov supply lines. And these Jaegers moving up here, probably going to want something to help deal with that. Still, good harassment, good consistent harassment here from Luciano versus Nosmarkov. Got the lieutenant holding up the center as Nosmarkov's launching an assault there as well. Take up for Nosmarkov, share punted to quarters, inbound eventually. We'll have to see when the Luciano begins taking up. Ooh, quick grenade there. Not pushing for the fuel, he might be a bit worried here about other light vehicles, have something else planned. Stuart Light tank with 7 kills, Luke's with 6, and the Puma with none. There you go, fuel pump being hit, he needs to get something on that soon. He really can't afford to fall behind Nosmarkov and fuel much more. Counter attack on the curve point there as Nosmarkov's trying to claim. There you go, light vehicle column backed up by infantry, he's going to try and put a bit of debt here in Luciano's eastern forces. There you go, 50 cavalry reels itself. Carve point reclaimed, Jaegers barely took any damage there. Looks is swiftly rushing in, we got the Bazooka team nearby, and what is this? Oh, it's a demo charge by Luciano's assault units. Clever, if Nosmark at any point tries to use the church, he's going to set off the charge and likely kill the unit inside. Very nice work there by Luciano. They probably wants to do the same with some of those buildings there. Assault units lieutenant here pinned down behind the wreckage of a noble blitz. They're not going to make it much further here. Luke's being repaired, 50 cover coming at the calf point. Raven, they could advance a bit further. The right flank in the west. Oh no. Lost at least one Raven squad here. That is bad news for Luciano. Great though for Nosmarkov. His spare punch squad's yet to go up. Ooh, the forces here. More assault units out here to replace the losses. Jaegers moving ahead. Will they occupy the church? Will he blow them apart? Will he realize it? Oh, he can't see it. He can't see it. He can't detonate it. That can be the unfortunate bit with us. You don't actually see it. You know, can't detonate. But as soon as he sees it with the stud, he should have a chance to make a yoga boom. Ooh, almost got a wipe here. Blow the charge and there you go, Jaeger's gone. Nice little trap there by Luciano. Costing Nosmarkov there. Jaeger's caught quite a blow there. You'd have been more cautious about that, to be honest. A rifleman moving out the west and the east. We've got the Sturmbannen up being with the Sturmbannen. 50 cal backing up here. And veterinary to the almost getting wiped here on the Sturmbannen. Luciano is only heading in hard there. He needs to take up soon. We already got Nosmarkov with the strap punch. He's almost done there. It's going to make it much harder for Luciano to harass without any sort of serious anti-tank weapons. There you go. Routed. This assault, the ace assault unit is there, pushed back by the Fair Panzer headquarters. Also need to reclaim that calf point again. Oh, he's going for the captain? That doesn't make a lot of sense. I mean, I guess he wants the anti-tank guns out, but honestly, I do feel like he's a bit off. He's trying to go for something a bit bigger in terms of armored level, but that's just me. Puma on the move here. Raph needs to retreat now. Even then, it could be too late. We got the tender covering up the retreat. Nice little bazooka shot there from the top floor, hitting the victory point at least. And turn that regard, Luciano is slightly edging ahead here from Nosmarkov. 395 is a 369. Studio opening up. 15 kills. Sturmbannen is on the way. Let's replace the ones Nosmarkov lost earlier. Which case, worth noting, he has an upgrade here with the repair pioneers. Captain almost down there for Luciano. I imagine he'll be seeing a couple of anti-tank guns at least. And Puma is actually close being taken out, but says the steward. One piece of announce there popped up. Oh, he's baiting it. Close here. Very close for either side, but in the other case, the vehicle escapes. Fun fact about the Puma was actually produced in very small numbers because German High Command was worried it would make the reconnaissance crews too combat eager since they're just there to reconnaissance, you know, instead of you. And so basically discontinued. They went back to the 234-1, which just had a 270 cannon, autocannon like the 2-2-2, and then they also made some variants for the truck either with a pack 40 or a 75mm cannon for sort of support to help deal with bigger stuff, but again, not in a way that caused them to be hyper aggressive. So, a little fun fact there. Got the captain reassurance moving up the center. Jaeger's about here. Luciano in a much stronger position was in the early game, and again, that sort of highlights the difference there. They can sort of end up the Oberkommando versus UCF dynamic. Oberkommando pushes in early, but then loses ground, and then it's sort of trying to use that early advantage to push back and win the game. If they fail, they'll be crushed. And now it looks like Luciano's the one with the stronger hand. Of course, Nos Markov's going to be trying to push for armor, and Luciano so far is not pushing for it. Again, he's likely going to back up there and take tank guns before pushing for armor. Nice handing up the Puma here, though, by Nos Markov. We don't actually get a lot of Puma play sets, in particular if they are playing with Overwatch, and most players who go for Pumas nowadays are the ones, you know, trying to stall into Command Panther. So it's actually nice to see here that Nos Markov isn't just playing the average Oberkommando West game at all. Quick one hand grenade off here. Still a bit of loss there for Luciano by the looks of it. And it got wiped out. I'm not sure which one. Oh, the assault engineers. Ace 1 push back here. Captain pinned down by the MG34 here. Nice position by the restaurant. Stood moving up to engage the Jaegers, but the Puma push in the back there. Half eight of Etchon 3. Really solid Puma handling. And the West Rifleman Lieutenant there, trying to break through the Western Garden here, but sadly, Nos Markov's men are barring the way with furious intensity. Back here, troops in reinforcement. Get a pack out from Louisiana. That's actually not what I was anticipating. Again, I kind of figured he'd be worrying more about armor and bringing out anti-tank guns, but a pack howitzer is not a bad choice. It's a really good artillery piece and has a really good chance of wiping units up if you use it actively. Nos Markov, meanwhile, going for the Kedon effort. Also, kind of figured, you know, he'd go for the bulldozer shim and he really wants something a bit more explosive, but I guess he really wants, you know, something otherwise armored first. So, interesting build order here that Luciano's got going versus Nos Markov. Still very close to the ace level. There we go. Got the Puma again. Bazooka team opening up, even as against suppressed by the MG34. Stuart trying to help finish off, but not quite landing that killing blow. There you go. Kednev out there for Nos Markov for the 9th Panzer Division. Rifle as a fault going to do this. I mean, at this stage, Luciano probably wants to equip some of his rifle with bars, or maybe consider upgrading with grenades. So there's a bit way of clearing up stuff there. Captain has been barred up as well. Got the assault units hard at work, routing crowds. And there you go, Nos Markov with the Panther on the way. Looks well, it has been blown up at some point, and we got the pack crowds are firing off there. But a Panzer Kampfwagen here for Nos Markov and the 9th Panzer Division. Flares off as Luciano launches another assault to reclaim the town center. In the west, Cap moving up here. Straight into the Shroud Panther quarter. Seems like he forgot about that one a bit for a brief moment. Trying to push here the under support of 50 Cavalry Fire and, of course, the Pack House machine gun is coming up nicely here as well. And the assault for Luciano did not quite pan out the way he had hoped. Hitting that victory point again. He's certainly keeping up the lead here versus Nos Markov. And the German army here stood moving in so close to the A's level. But now the real challenge arrives as the Panzer IV hits the field here from Nos Markov. Captain misses false grenadiers. In this case, Captain loses out. And gets wiped. That is definitely not a good development there for Luciano, particularly now that the Panzer IV's arrived. Upgrading with the Pinelmut machine gun there for added anti-infantry fun. Rifle Lieutenant moving up, got the pack out to the firing away. Hammering at the Hun. Puma firing away, they're close to Vetchin 23. Fixing up the sword light chain there. Pretty close to the front line though. Pretty close. I feel like this is a bit of a mistake there by. Yeah, bit of a mistake there. In with the elite vehicle crew there, the base allowed to repair. Faster, that's still pretty ambitious to repair that close. Got the Panther Wing, this could be a bit of a repeating mistake here by him. He's gonna, there we go, use the Shell Shock here to allow the Stutz to escape the Panzer IV here as much as possible, but he's only got bazookas to stop it, and the bazookas are rather in awkward spots as well, so he might have made a mistake here with the Stutz. Tries on the rope. Oh! Close one there, but didn't succeed. This Yana got punished. He's, I think, yeah, he's teched out now, but it's taking some time for getting an armor out. And without the captain, he can't even say rush out a tank destroyer to meet the Panzer IV head on, so Luciano might have made a few miscalculations here versus Nos Markov, but he might be able to get a wipe here in the west at the very least. Which, of course, is not going to fix everything, but it's going to make it hurt less. There we go. It's like a band-aid, you know, it has a nice psychological effect. And maybe helps a bit. But anyways, Panzer IV moving up here, close to half health. Puma very close to Veteran 3 as well. And there we go. We got the Jackson away, the Feliciano. A big fat tank destroyer. No M10s for now, though. Could theoretically going to try and pop up two of those, getting out some numbers. Damaging the Panzer IV loose on the east side here as well. Nos Markov is looking rather ascendant once more. He is looking mean. Back here, troops healing and reinforcing. Assault unit is being wet eastwards there to flush out any Germans. Puma still hanging back here, enjoying a bit of shade there from the nearby tree. Trap hunters, of course, they're routing the rifle and seeing almost another wipe here on Luciano. More or less at the same spot as the captain got wiped. That would have been quite uncomfortable. And he ends up losing it in the end as well. Ah. Luciano needs more cover at that western victory point. And his infantry is also starting to look a bit ragged. A bit worn out. Packard there so far has not led to any amazing results here for Luciano so far, sadly. I imagine in part because Nos Markov has been playing a lot more fluid and aggressively, which does lead to Packard being a bit less effective. So, that and, well, we'll have to see how the Jackson does. But I think Luciano needs to look into some medium tanks after this. He needs something to help deal with infantry. But it's going to take some time since he's got control of very little of the map now. He's got no control of the fuel points as well. Hands have almost fixed up. Packard's playing it. Almost getting the MG-34 crew there entirely. Very good, very good. And they got annihilated. Ooh, those assault units on them might risk getting an eye as they push straight ahead here into the town centre with low health and no real support. Jack's moving up, directed in the Panzer IV here, penetrating the frontal armour with ease. Packard are firing away there. Rather close range, got to kill there. Look, big silence. Then in the east, Puma there close, being destroyed here with the Viersons with the bazookas. We've got Fulton and Panzer IV coming up here. Puma escapes, though. Puma escapes. I think Luciano's going to need to focus in the centre, trying to just push through there with raw force. And it's causing him to just commit forces. He can't really afford anyways to just be committed in such a way. It makes it much easier for Nos Markov to defend, so I think Luciano's going to have to change up his tactics. Oh, almost got the Panzer IV there. I doubt he can finish off there. It would be pretty great here for Luciano if he could. Oh, he's trying to, I think, get here with the pack howitzer. Close one there, but no dice. Jackson being fixed up, ramping up with 5th cover support in the east. A Kedmeth, a wipe, that's kind of helpful there for Luciano, particularly if he can steal it away here from Nos Markov. Finding around the car point here, falls the club being rubbed out. Nos Markov might be getting a bit too green in his defense here against Luciano, and that is causing some rather horrific casualties. Though did get a wipe there, Lieutenant is down, and Luciano has very little infantry left now. Luciano really needs to, you know, sort that out on top of all the other things he needs to sort out. There we go, Swamp Unit is out there. And we got another Panzer IV from Nos Markov. Honestly, just rush that one of the assault units. I mean, you can grab the Kedna from the MD-34 there. That would be pretty helpful versus some. Him, but there you go. Machine Recruit needs to strong the Kedna to ensure it does not fall into the hands of Luciano and the second Armored. These points being reclaimed here. And the former Stannis soldier is moving up here, burning away. I can never destroy it. Falls are being burned up. Got veterans won the pack house there, of course. 5 kills. Ooh, that could get really ugly. Close one, they actually got a perfect hit. I mean, if you go and say the Falsker's Ward and the MD Fed full crit at the same time, that would have been pretty nuts there for Luciano. I mean, he'd not be entirely out of the, you know, woods, but he'd be in a slightly better position they could land such a blow. Another 50 cap hit, he'll be the infantry. The Panther 4, those growing in number, will be a problem here for Luciano, as he's still very light on sort of serious anti-tank firepower. I mean, two Panther 4s, Jackson and Colbert versus Jackson and a Colbert Sugars is going to be a bit of a tricky challenge there. Particularly since also Academy are still creeping about here. That could very well threaten to, you know, make things much more complicated. Assault unit is routed. Bazooka team moving up here. In the midst of everything, and there you go, Panther 4 just lands the hit. Moving up to Jackson here. Pack out to firing. Closer there, actually, but also very close to Veteran 2. He's also theoretically not far off from getting a Sherman tank, and certainly that could help just in A dealing with infantry, but also drawing fire away from the Jackson. So there'd be a lot of reason there to go for it. And there you go, Pentacle's going to flank the Jackson. That's going to be pretty bad. Oh, shot bounced. There you go, Pentacle hit the other Panther 4. Other Panther 4 moving in, though. Need to be careful with the Jackson, since two Panther 4s versus one Jackson is, unless Nos Marcos really unlucky, is going to be favored for him due to simply having higher firepower levels. There we go. Almost got one Panther 4 here. That could be helpful for Luciano. Oh, Panther 4 blocks the route. Oh, and the island getting ambushed. There you go. Got the Jax. Oh, the Panther. No, it's only abandoned, and the Jackson goes down. Oh, 9. Pretty bad development there for Luciano. Critical, in fact. Jackson is down, and the Panther 4 did not get destroyed. So he's dealing with the reaction of the Rakedner for there. Close getting white machine gun setting up again in the west ground. The victory point here. Bazooka found the Panther 4 pack out of firing as well. Not think heat rounds there, which could always help. Now you go for the thing in Narsi, and we got Veteran 2 up for the pack counter. 239 versus 201. The situation is rough. Will he try and go for another Jackson? Will he go for the M10 tank destroyer instead, as that one is cheaper? They could maybe build up a couple of them. That would try and take on the tanks. Noting that he's going for another Panzer 4. Abandoned one is so far ignored. Will Luciano go for the Jackson? He's going for the M10. He's just going for what is faster. He probably realizes he can't afford to wait for it. 50 caliber rounded here. So, yeah, quite a challenging situation for Luciano. As Marco, though, of course, is not getting his way either entirely. There you go, Puma moving up. You should be spotting here that there's an abandoned Panther 4 which you could try and salvage. There you go, wrapping by the cop on here, taking heavy fire there from Nosmarkov's armor pool. But the Puma's actually yet to hit Veteran 3. In fact, the Puma's been out of the fight for some time. He's just been forgetting about it, I guess. And there you go, M10 tank strike here for Luciano the Wolverine. Sitting out there. Will this be enough, though, against the armored might of Nosmarkov and the 9th Panzer Division? That's certainly quite a chance. There you go. Going straight ahead here. Overdrive, or flanking speed right away. Pretty aggressive stuff here. Bazooka team's opening up and might have a chance here. There you go. Panzer 4 down. A small help here for Luciano. There might still be hope here. There might still be a chance, but you still need to be careful about the Kenevs and the likes. And of course, mindful of the Puma, which could very quickly leave the M10 to the back spot. And there you go, quickly flanking, popping smoke. There you go, direct hit there. Veterans 1, that's not going to help us, the Puma, since it doesn't have anything with firepower. We got Veteran 3 and the Puma increasing its damage, which is actually pretty bad for the M10. Don't pursue! Oh no, and the assault is going to die. Ah, desperate stuff here for Luciano. He's trying to squeeze out as much as he can of every single unit here versus Luciano to push them beyond the limits. And the problem is, every time he does, he just pushes them into the grave at times. Ooh, direct hit from the pack out there on the Panzer IV, doing a nice bit of damage there. Very good. Problem is, the other one got recruit and is back in action for Nosmarkov. Sadly, Luciano got to now, then otherwise, I think he'd be in a stronger position here versus the German army. Panzer moving ahead. Almost got the Jaegers here wiped with the pack howitzer. I mean, once he gets invention, he becomes really good. M10 back in action. He can soon go for another one in two M10s. Could very well offer him what he needs as a Panzer IV. Down to 100 points, though. Panzer IV routed. More Jaegers out here for Nosmarkov to quickly flesh out his ranks as he's bleeding out units now. Direct hit by the kennel on the M10, Panther on the east side. Bazooka team's on watch. Puma and Dynamite repairs. Still no repair pioneers at the base, probably there for Nosmarkov. I would say that's a bit of an oversight.
We're down to 75 points.
73 points. Got a Fulton squad guarding the west point there. Seems still coming up here. A kid recruit that's going to get wiped. We got Sector Assault here ready for Nosmarkov. The Kenner almost done but doesn't quite make it. There you go. Assault is pushed back. Sector Strike going in or Sector Assault going in. Oh dear. And this Luciano who can't go for a, I believe, second M10 now? Yes, sir. Second M10. If you so desire. Definitely needs to go for something before it's too late. Heavy bombing strike around here, by the sound of it. 50 points left. Bring in with the M10 against the Panther IV. Shoots, misses. Quick reload here for the M10 tank to show the crew against the Panther IV. Second shot bounces off the Panther IV's armor. And a bombing strike that almost takes out the 5th cavalry crew. We got Attila called in here on the center against Nosmarkov. 41 points left here for Luciano.
41 points left. 39 points left.
Oh, close one there. Taking out the Volkswagen set. The house goes down. Another bit, they're being blown up. Jaeger's hanging back at half 8 to 24, soldiers moving in. Oh, bombing strike going in. They're almost taking out the M10. The Packard's crew goes down. And that Luciano surrenders, his spirit broken, his forces unable to advance. A close fight, I think it's old times here. Luciano struggled in the early game, but I think came around the mid game. The problem was, I think, like, he should have just, I think, ignored the company command post, pushed straight here for the Batan command post, trying to get out armor as fast as possible versus Nosmarkov instead. I think he did it then while the pack cards came around long term. I think he should have just pushed for more direct armor edge versus Nosmarkov. Though, of course, that's just my opinion here. Nosmarkov, I think they did plenty well, though otherwise, not so much to critique there. Though, again, he could have probably at times flanked once, only also Luciano at times, I think, got a bit too focused on the center there. So, there you go. Hope you enjoyed this match. Hope you learned something from it. If you did, subscribe, like, share, comment on it. Tell your friends, tell your family. But don't tell your enemies. This is ImproLinkedIn. Cheers. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you all tomorrow again for another episode. Bye.